Hello from Chem Help ASAP. Let's see how strong nucleophiles react with epoxides to give ring open products. Let's start with opening epoxides with weak nucleophiles. This reaction is pulled from the previous video in this playlist. It's an opening under acidic conditions. Note that a weak nucleophile doesn't have the reactivity to open the ring by itself. It has to wait for the epoxide to be activated by protonation. That's this structure here in the middle. The positive charge then makes the epoxide more electrophilic and attracts the weak nucleophile, which attacks at the more hindered side of the epoxide. We also get inversion of stereochemistry at the attacked carbon. Now let's move to the opening of epoxides with strong nucleophiles at the bottom of the screen. Very often these reactions are under basic conditions. We'll start with the same epoxide. In this case, however, we have a very reactive nucleophile in sodium methoxide. The oxygen is an anion and it needs no help in attacking the epoxide. It attacks, however, at the less highly substituted side of the epoxide. We then use the solvent, methanol in this case, to protonate the negatively charged oxygen. Two comments here. One, note that the stereochemistry of the central carbon is unchanged. No bonding changes have occurred, so stereochemistry is unchanged. Two, for this example, there is no stereochemistry at the carbon that was attacked. If there had been, we would have seen inversion at this carbon. That being said, you often don't have stereocenters at the attacked carbon because it's often an end carbon, the less hindered carbon. We now have a second method for opening an epoxide. It uses a strong nucleophile, which attacks at the less substituted side of the epoxide. You do get inversion at the attacked carbon if the carbon is a stereocenter, but often it isn't.